quietly. The next item of business is a member's business debate on motion 4703 in the name of Willie Rennie on the future of Elmwood Campus. This debate will be concluded without any questions being put, and I'd ask those members who wish to speak in the debate to press the request to speak buttons now. And I call on Willie Rennie to open the debate. Mr Rennie, 7 minutes or thereabouts, please.
Thank you, Deputy Presiding Officer. You encourage the members in the gallery to leave quietly. Of course, they could stay if they wish to listen to this debate.
Yes, you may stay if you wish to be entertained by Mr Rennie.
I am grateful for the opportunity to debate Elmwood Campus, formerly Elmwood College in Cupar in my constituency. It's a great seat of learning that is open for business with great staff, students and courses. The bad news is this. According to the Scottish Funding Council, and I quote, following the transfer of Fife College's offer at Elmwood Campus to other campuses in the area, provision at the Elmwood Campus of Scotland's Rural College, SRUC, is no longer viable. Now, the good news is, I know the Minister will be keen to assist and will want to provide sufficient guarantees to ensure there is a vibrant centre of education in the heart of North East Fife for years to come. I want her to broker an agreement with Fife College and SRUC, find the revenue for student activity to ensure a critical mass of activity, and a new building to replace the existing ageing buildings. Now, Elmwood began its life back in the 50s with around 100 students, with a new purpose building in the 60s before becoming Elmwood Agricultural and Technical College, the first regional farm centre in Scotland in 1972 with around 2,000 students. Strathedon Hospital Farm was purchased in 1971 to offer hill farming and shepherding courses. In 1997, the college became the first education establishment in Britain to have its own 18-hole working golf course. Only 9 miles from St Andrews, the golf is recognised globally. Students of the HNC and HND in professional golf have found careers as PGA assistants at world-famous clubs such as Gullen, North Berwick, Ladybank, Royal Troon, and numerous clubs across Europe and Dubai. Elmwood became part of the SRUC on October the 1st, 2012. Today, the Scottish Rural College Elmwood Campus offers courses in animal care, sport, golf, greenkeeping, horticulture, hospitality and rural skills. So what is the problem? Well, the problem is when the government decided to split Elmwood between Fife College and the SRUC, the settlement was inherently unstable. SRUC had a well-publicised leadership issues, and there are clear financial issues too, with significant cuts imposed by the Scottish Government to the FE budget. Elmwood was left rudderless. SRUC were uncommunicative and unresponsive to concerns from Fife College and their own staff in Cupar. The sale of the farm and courses moving to other centres such as Oatridge compounded the problem. The division of the campus between Fife College and SRUC created instability, with Fife claiming it was unsustainable for them. They had none of the assets but were expected to pay for a share of the costs. Fife College subsequently, rather hastily, pulled out, promising to provide entry-level courses in local schools such as Bell Baxter High School, which has not happened. So the combination of the withdrawal of Fife and some of the courses by SRUC having left Elmwood Campus underutilised. So that is why the current setup has been judged by the Scottish Funding Council as not viable. Now, North East Fife has a long agricultural heritage. That was the reason for the location of the college in the first place. With the home of golf at St Andrews on its doorstep, the golf provision, both in terms of greenkeeping and sport, is a clear draw for students. North East Fife is a rural and remote area and needs a further education provision to provide access locally. And we have a centre of learning with excellent staff operating right now. These are the reasons why the college in Cupar is essential. We will need a new building which is fit for purpose and combines the needs for rural education with SRUC and further education through Fife College. The current building has a significant maintenance cost attached, so needs to be replaced. If I can gently say to the Minister that these problems only really began when the regionalisation of colleges was introduced by the government, and I would therefore equally gently suggest that the government has a responsibility to secure a longer-term future. The Scottish Funding Council has issued a tender for a study to be done. It is entitled North East Fife FE Curriculum Study, and it starts as follows. Following the transfer of Fife College's offer at Elmwood Campus to other campuses in the area, provision at Elmwood Campus of Scotland Rural College is no longer viable. As a consequence, there is a need, through an evidence-based study, to identify the curriculum needs for the area and develop a viable model for its delivery. And the remit is as follows: to identify an appropriate curriculum offer for North East Fife that meets the economic needs and student demand for the area, to consider and identify speciality courses aligned with the economic development strategy for North East Fife that would attract students from outside of the area, to identify a viable delivery model for the area, including shared and co-location options. That sounds promising. The trouble is that the work is to be carried out through March and April, but to be ready for the academic year 2018 and 2019, we need decisions to be made now. We need the combination of rural education and further education, including both entry-level and full-time FE courses. And this needs to be provided in the Cupar area in a new building. So we need a joint plan, funding for more student places, and a new building. That is the challenge for the Minister today, and I do look forward to her response.
Thank you very much, Mr. Rennie. I call Jenny Gilruth, be followed by Liz Smith. Ms. Gilruth, please.
Thank you, Presiding Officer, and can I thank Willie Rennie too for bringing forward today's motion on Elmwood Campus in Cupar. When I was growing up, it was known as Elmwood College. You could go there to get your hair cut. Indeed, my friends and I regularly did for the bargain price of £10, which, Presiding Officer, as you might know, I have a little more hair than Willie Rennie, so I'm sure you will agree was quite a bargain in the year of 2001. In your last year at school, you could go and study for a higher in psychology, allowing many of my friends to pick up the extra credits they needed to get into university. And every May, my mum and others from all over North East Fife would descend upon the college at the summer open day to locate the perfect hanging baskets beautifully planted and prepared by the students. And it is, of course, of vital importance to the rural economy in the northern part of the kingdom. For the future gamekeepers and farmers, it continues today to provide a stepping stone from school into employment for many. I met previously with the former principal of the college, Hugh Logan, and Mr. Logan was of the view that there were issues with regard to the maintenance of college buildings and that this issue with estates was not specific to the Cupar campus. Last year I visited the new Leavenmouth College campus where full-time programmes were transferred from Elmwood. My colleague David Torrance MSP and I met with lecturers and students to discuss their experiences within the new building. Beauty students now have access to state-of-the-art facilities with treatment rooms. Hair students have access to a modern salon, childcare students to spacious tutorial rooms and Wi-Fi access across the building. The campus has been supported by £25 million of investment from the Scottish Government and it sits alongside the new Leavenmouth Academy. A lot of the staff in the new building have to travel, however, from North East Fife to their new workplace in Buckhaven. And whilst the facilities are excellent and the staff were positive about their surroundings, transport links to the new campus are still in their infancy. Many of my constituents in the Glenrothes area spoke of the difficulties they've had in terms of accessing the buses, some having to catch two or three different buses and the infrequency of the service as well. And this issue is perhaps even more so when you consider the reality of North East Fife and the distances people travel from places like Taypor or Anstruther, for example, along in the East Nuke. But on a specific point with regard to my constituency, I would be remiss in my duty as a constituency member for Mid Fife and Glenrothes not to emphasise the importance of infrastructure to the Minister today, particularly the need for the reinstatement of the Leavenmouth rail link. Education and closing the poverty-related attainment gap is the number one priority for the Scottish Government, but we need the transport links to join up aspiration and ambition in the next generation to enable young people to access the vital learning and job opportunities. And this is of particular importance when you consider that in the 2015-16, the college delivered 8.4% of activities to students from the country's 10% most deprived areas. That's an increase from 8.2% in 2014-15 and 7.9% in 13-14 respectively, so things are getting worse. Since last summer, though, Elmwood Campus has been run completely by Elmwood's rural college, as Willie Rennie has said, and the land-based courses, which Elmwood has always had a good reputation for, continue to run. Things like gamekeeping, wildlife management, horticulture, and a selection of golf and greenkeeping-related qualifications. Notwithstanding, the government has recognised the need to review curriculum provision, and since the end of last month, rocket science consultants have been commissioned to do exactly that. So whilst I am the member for the neighbouring constituency, I very much hope that rocket science consultants reconsider curriculum provision at Elmwood. Presiding officer, for the young people like me who grew up in the wee towns and villages of North East Fife where the buses aren't regular and there is no rail service, let's look again at Elmwood to ensure that all students and would-be students get access equal access to further education opportunities wherever they live in Fife. Thank you.
Just clarifying, it's Rocket Science Consultants.
Correct.
My
yeah.
goodness, there's a name. I call Liz Smith, but followed by Alec Rowley, please.
I hope, Deputy Presiding Officer, you're not thinking of changing your profession. Can I begin by thanking Willie Rennie for bringing this member's business to the Chamber today, and also for the motion that he has submitted in Parliament, and for giving us the opportunity to debate the future of Elmwood Campus and the Scottish Rural University College in Cupar. And may I take the opportunity to thank all the staff and the students for the outstanding work that they do, particularly in an area of North East Fife, which some consider to be a little more isolated in terms of accessing further and higher education, and the problems that Jenny Gilruth has just referred to in terms of making sure that they can actually get there. Along with St Andrews, Cupar is a town I know very well, and I admire its very proud agricultural heritage and its role as a very important market town for the surrounding area. Its economy reflects that heritage, with major employers in the area, including obviously agribusiness such as Kettle Produce Limited, Scots Fruit Limited, Quaker Oats Limited, and Fisher and Donaldson. But of course, one of the other large employers in the town is the Elmwood campus itself. Part of that agricultural heritage in the area, and that's just one of the strong reasons for ensuring that everything possible is done to secure its future. And Willie Rennie is quite right to point to the challenges facing the college at a time of financial stringency, of changing roles for colleges, of the widening access programme, colleges being asked to deliver more in terms of higher education courses, and the ongoing challenges faced by the post-merger era, which he referred to, and which Audit Scotland said in its most recent report that has brought some additional pressures. The three parts to Elmwood campus on the Carslogie Road itself, the golf course facility at Strathaven, which was 1997, I think, and Cupar Muir Farm, have all had their very distinctive courses on offer, whether these be in animal care, sport, horticulture, cookery, whatever it might be. And as today's motion notes, the college has been especially well known for its golf and greenkeeping courses, in which it's had world-leading expertise and has produced a number of most distinguished golfing alumni. The facilities at the college campus in Strathaven are excellent, given that it is the only educational facility in the country with its own 18-hole golf course. And where better to have it as a short hop away from St Andrews and the home of golf. Clearly, in recent times, there has been a history of difficult issues at the college, whether that has been some of the weaknesses in collaboration between Fife College and SRUC, the tough financial cuts which colleges have faced, or concerns about future job cuts. And naturally, with the SFC now questioning some of the viability of Elmwood set against that economic background, staff and students have a right to feel somewhat threatened when it comes to the educational opportunities available and the obvious implications that that has for staff morale and indeed student morale. So can I add my support to what Willie Rennie has said about the splitting of Elmwood between Fife College and SRUC and the inherent instability of that arrangement? And whilst I recognise that there is a funding issue here, and I think it's quite a big funding issue, I think he's right to call for measures that can put the college on a more sustainable footing. College education is really vital because it has the best chance of responding quickly to the needs of the local economy, whether that's in the term of apprenticeships, part-time, more flexible courses, which obviously, sadly, have been the ones that have suffered in so many of the recent cuts, or responding to a more diverse and fast-changing labour market. and both of these could hardly be more important in an area where the access to further education is perhaps a little bit more limited than it is in some other areas. I think that diversity and provision of responding to needs of local economies is one of the most powerful arguments. So the call for the Minister to broker a deal on an agreement between Fife College and SRUC is an important one. I think there is a lot that we can do to try and move that process forward, and I hope the Minister will take up that point. Now, I do understand this is a difficult situation, and it's got a backdrop against some of the difficult challenges within the college sector, but I do give support to Willie Rennie in this, that hopefully we can move things forward, so I'm happy to support the motion.
Thank you very much. I call Alec Rowley to be followed by Mark Ruskell. Mr. Rowley, please.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I also would like to speak briefly in support of Willie Rennie's motion that he's brought here today, and to recognise the campaign that Willie Rennie has been running over a period of time to get recognition of the difficulties that the college faces. And I think that is an important point to make to the Minister, because Mr. Rennie is calling on the Minister to give a guarantee that the government will take steps necessary to ensure the future viability of the college. And that's a campaign, I think, that would be supported not just in North East Fife, but a campaign that would be supported right across Fife. Elmwood College has played an important part in Fife over many, many years, not just in terms of the agricultural industry that is predominant to North East Fife, but is also an industry that is creates jobs right across Fife. But also, I certainly know that from a very early age, I was aware of Elmwood College because one of my cousins decided to have a career as a gardener and attended Elmwood College when I was a little boy and recently retired. So it was his whole life was a career as a gardener, and a very successful one, and he learnt his trade at Elmwood College. I also have many friends that work in golf courses that I've had the experience, apprentice gardeners. I started off my working life working for the local authority as a gardener, and therefore I've always been familiar with Elmwood College. I also, a few years ago, attended an event organised by the Fife Society for the Blind when they opened specific facilities at Elmwood College that had been gifted through a local trust, the investment. And I remember at that time also meeting a number of pupils and tutors from a specialist support unit that was in the college at that time that supported people on the autistic spectrum. And the provision and the support that was there was second to none. So Elmwood College has played an important part in Fife. And I think to reiterate that point, the split that came between Fife College and the Scottish Rural College has not worked out for Elmwood College. But there are a number of reasons that are set out today by Mr. Rennie as to why that would be the case. And one of them is the actual building itself. And part of the ask has got to be that if we're serious about continuing with Elmwood College, then we need to look at the actual facilities themselves. Kenneth Gibson in the First Minister's question talked about a bumper year for tourism. I spoke at an event last night in Dunfermline where we were launching an ambitious programme for a national artworks to be in the Dunfermline area up at Kelty at Junction 4. And the point I made was that far too often we have that wonderful new bridge that's there. We have the two other fourth bridges, the road bridge and the fourth bridge. People come to Edinburgh tourism, then come across those bridges right up through Fife, out the other side of Fife and up into the Highlands. And we need to do more for people to actually stay in Fife. We have some of the best golf courses and most famous golf courses in the country. The outdoor facilities, Lahore Meadows Country Park, There's a lot of ambition in Fife to develop the outdoor activities. Outdoor tourism in Fife is a major contributor to the Fife
economy.
Can
I ask you to wind up on this tourist plug for Fife? I'm a bit lost about Elmwood College in this.
and therefore the role of Elmwood College in providing the support, the training and the skills, presiding officer, to develop that tourism in Fife is crucial. So we need the investment in Elmwood. I'm happy to support Mr Rennie today.
Yes, I shouldn't try to teach an old dog you tricks. You got me there. Can I call Mark Ruskell, followed by Dean Lockhart, last speaker in the open debate, Mr Lockhart.
Thank you, Deputy Presiding Officer, and can I thank Willie Rennie for bringing this debate to the Chamber here this lunchtime, and also his wider efforts in championing a sustainable future for Elmwood College. I know he's worked on this for many years. I think it's been clear, though, that for a number of years, the arrangements at Elmwood have not been living up to the needs of the communities that it serves, and I think it's regrettable that it's now come to a crisis point. And I'd like to just briefly consider the wider context of Elmwood's situation and highlight some points that I hope the SFC study that's currently underway will take into account. So firstly, on the issue of college regionalisation that Willie Rennie raised, while it's fair to say that regionalisation process instigated by the SNP government the last session has had its troubles, I think it's important to also acknowledge that regionalisation is not the sole reason the situation at Elmwood has arisen. In fact, the University of the Highlands and Islands provides a world-leading example of how, when well done, regionalising education provision can have huge benefits to some of our most rural areas, creating opportunities for study, work and specialist training right in the heart of communities that need it. Now, the initial partnership between SRUC and Fife College at Elmwood was an acknowledgement that the campus delivered specialist rural training and education that Fife College was not able to provide. With proper support and willingness on all sides, this could have been a fruitful partnership. And I would urge the SFC and ministers to learn from the example set by UHI and its partnerships with specialist institutions such as North Atlantic Fisheries College and Selmore Ostake to see how this can be done successfully. But we should also recognise the wider challenges facing both the further education sector and our rural communities more generally, which have contributed to making college provision at Elmwood untenable. The lack of clear and accessible financial support for college students continues to make further education an unattractive prospect for many people. And in our own manifesto last year, we called for funding parity between college and university students, so those studying institutions such as Elmwood can have the same certainty of financial support that their friends studying at university receive. Now, implementing this could have a major impact on college admissions, not just at Elmwood, but across the further education sector. But as Jenny Gilruth has already highlighted, the patchy and increasingly expensive public transport service in North East Fife is also a contributing factor, with many people finding they may as well travel to Perth, Dundee or St Andrews for education as battling their way on a slow local bus service to Cupar. And I would encourage the SFC to consider these wider problems of our rural communities when designing a suitable model for further education in North East Fife. And if we're to provide funding to create further college places, we need to ensure these are on courses that people want to study and delivered in a way that suits their lifestyles. We know that North East Fife has an older than average population to the rest of Scotland. In reality, many prospective students are not school leavers, but are of working age or older people who want to return to employment after a break, fit in study around caring responsibilities, or learn a new skill later in life. Yet the pattern we've seen in recent years of cutting part-time and flexible learning courses to focus on full-time vocational training does not always suit the needs of this demographic and may well be a major contributor to the fall in student numbers which we've seen at Elmwood, which, to be honest, has been in decline some time before Fife College actually withdrew from the campus. Lastly, I'd like to commend the work of the Supported Accommodation Service at Elmwood. I think Alex Rowley has already mentioned this, which provides safe and supported living for 7 SRUC students who have additional needs. This kind of provision is all too rare and faces its own financial challenges, often relying on additional funding from third-party organisations and families. I'd strongly advise the SFC to help maintain and enhance this service. Thank you.
Thank you very much. I call Dean Lockhart. Mr Lockhart, please.
Thank you, Deputy Presiding Officer. Let me start by thanking Willie Rennie for bringing this motion to the Chamber and securing this important debate today on the future of Elmwood Campus. Elmwood Campus is located in Cupar, as we've heard, which is the historic county town in Fife, with a strong history in agriculture and is still regarded as an important market town. The area around Cupar is also well known, as we've heard, for its world-famous golf courses, with the campus being only 9 miles from St Andrews. Given this agricultural and golfing background, it's not surprising that Elmwood is well known for offering a range of agricultural and golf-related courses. Before looking at some of the challenges faced by the campus, I think it's worthwhile considering the benefits and future potential of the diverse range of courses on offer. The agricultural courses on offer help provide rural businesses across Scotland with a well-skilled workforce. Scotland's rural industry is constantly changing, and in order to meet the needs of this industry and provide students with the necessary skills base, we should be supporting colleges such as Elmwood in developing this growing range of specialist education. Mm-hmm. In relation to the golfing education available, Elmwood has gained global recognition as a premier training provider to the golf industry, not only in Scotland, but it is increasingly involved in activities beyond the UK and attracts many students from overseas. The golf programmes lead to degree and master degree courses and provision. The campus, I think, is quite rightly positioning itself as being the home of golf education, and there is a huge market that it can potentially look to serve. The golf industry in the UK is expanding and employs over 75,000 people. Golfers in the UK spent over £4 billion on the sport last year, and golf tourism to Scotland is also a major part of the tourist sector in Scotland. Given this unique offering from the Elmwood campus, I would urge the Minister to also have a conversation with her colleagues in the economy brief to see what Scottish Development International can do to promote the various golf courses to students overseas. Yep. An increase of students from overseas would help gain and create a critical mass of students, especially students in Asia, where the market for golf and golf knowledge is experiencing significant growth. I'm personally not a golf expert, but I can see the attractions of studying golf a mere 10 minutes away from the home of golf. On a less positive note, as Willie Rennie has highlighted, there are challenges in relation to achieving that critical mass of students and resources available at Elmwood. Other members have explained the detailed issues. I would just like to highlight a few of these. There is a local economy dimension to this debate. It's important to recognise the valuable contribution that the campus brings to North East Fife and the surrounding economy, its employment opportunities, the provision of skilled graduates, and the overall contribution to the local economy. In addition, further education options in North East Fife are limited, which makes this debate all the more important. To lose Elmwood campus would be a further blow to an area which has already seen a reduction in the availability of college courses who live in the Cupar area and surrounding towns. There is also a timing consideration. As Willie Rennie noted, the outcome of the study being undertaken by the SFC looking into possible alternative options will only be available for the academic year 2018-2019, which is not ideal. Students and staff are looking for clarity sooner rather than later, so I would encourage the Minister to look at the timetable as well. On this note, I would also like, as other members have done, like to praise both the staff and students who work and study at Elmwood campus, who remain committed to providing high-quality education and training in North East Fife. Deputy Presiding Officer, colleges play a critical role in our education system. However, there are now 150,000 fewer students in colleges than 10 years ago. Further cuts, especially in rural areas such as Cupar, would be unwelcome and damaging. So I would add my support to the calls on the Minister to encourage an agreement between Fife College and the SRUC on securing a viable future for the Elmwood campus. And I would like to thank Willie Rennie for bringing this debate to the Chamber. Thank you.
Thank you very much. I call Shirley Ann Summerall to close for the Government. Minister, 7 minutes or thereabouts.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. Can I begin by thanking Willie Rennie for bringing this debate to the Chamber? And I hope that we can all agree that we are effectively seeking the same thing for the people of Cupar and North East Fife more generally, and that's to have the right learning opportunities to meet the economic needs of the area. Presiding Officer, as you know, the Kingdom of Fife is a part of Scotland that is very close to my heart, and it's therefore not only from my position as Minister for Further Education, Higher Education and Science that I appreciate and understand the sentiment of Willie Rennie's motion, which I broadly welcome. And I and I hope the rest of the Chamber do fully understand the role that Elmwood has played in rural education in this country and the issues associated with Fife College vacating the campus from last summer. So I'm very pleased to be closing today's debate in order to outline how both institutions are being supported to ensure that the right solution is found for the residents of Cupar and North East Fife. Can I begin by mentioning some of the aspects which members have brought up? One of the concerns has been about the split between the courses between Fife and SRUC. That was done to ensure that SRUC can continue to focus and specialise on the land-based education which is their remit, and that's why the decision was taken to make the split between the courses. So this isn't something that's been done arbitrarily, and it's not something, as one of the members suggested, that was done by government, but done very much with a mind to the focus of what SRUC is all about. Other members have discussed regionalisation, and usually in a very negative format. Can I suggest that the talk to Hugh Hall, which I know Willie Rennie has already done, and he's met with them, the new principal of Fife College, who very much sees that regionalisation has allowed him to take the helm of a strong strategic institution. Yes, with its challenges, but regionalisation is not seen by the college as something that is holding it back, but rather that can take it forward to a much stronger position. As Willie Rennie has rightly pointed out, that following the transfer of Fife College's offer at Elmwood to other campuses in the region and concerns about the viability of Elmwood campus, the Scottish Funding Council is supporting a curriculum review of North East Fife, and I won't go into the details of the remit as Willie Rennie has already put that on the record. The Funding Council have appointed rocket science consultants at the end of February to take this work forward. And as well as having a wide range of relevant and experience, rocket science also have a very good knowledge of the area, having worked with Fife College in the past on its curriculum offer. As well as speaking to the SRUC and Fife College, the consultants are ensuring they will speak to key stakeholders in North East Fife, including Fife Council, schools, employers, third sector groups and universities. A comprehensive set of the area's existing data will also be interrogated as part of this work. This will include the Scottish Index of Multiple Deprivation, Labour Market Intelligence, Skills Investments Plans, Regional Skills Assessments, and we have my commitment that transport issues will be considered in that matter too. The study is due to be completed in the first week of May, and I look forward to it identifying a model for the area that works best for SRUC and Fife College, but most importantly, one that works best for the region and the people of North East Fife. It is my understanding that SRUC are currently in the process of developing a new strategic plan, and this will include a thorough review of their estate strategy. It will be important that they continue to have a dialogue with the Scottish Funding Council during this process. We have to recognise, however, that SRUC, as a higher education institution, is an autonomous body. It is not a college, and therefore has responsibility for its own strategic decision-making. The Scottish Government and Scottish Ministers are ultimately unable to intervene in their internal institutional matters, such as those relating to estates. We do, after all, hold dear the autonomy of our higher education institutions. But we would, however, expect the decisions to be made that will have a wider impact on Fife to be done in full consultation with staff and students, and that consideration is always given to the minimising the impact on the student experience. It is therefore encouraging that SRUC have stated that they have no plans to withdraw from the Elmwood campus and that they are actively recruiting students for the start of the 2017-18 academic year. Students will still have the opportunity to study a wide range of exciting courses, many of which the members have already mentioned, including gamekeeping, wildlife management, horticulture and a selection of the excellent golf and greenkeeping related qualifications. In 2014, SRUC was designated as the national provider for land-based education and was asked by the Scottish Funding Council to take a lead on the development of a national strategy of land-based education and training for the whole of Scotland. This is a dynamic strategy, and SRUC have been proactive in identifying the current and the future need of the land-based industries and works closely with its college and university partners to deliver a coherent land-based curriculum strategy for the sector that meets the needs of students, employers and the rural economy. The local presence of SRUC and its geographical reach are vital components to the delivery of the national strategy. And we fully recognise the overall contribution that SRUC make to the rural economy and the value that they bring to North East Fife. At a time when both SRUC and Fife College are taking stock of their estates and the provision which they have in offer, it is worth noting that both institutions are under relatively new leadership. Both have the right people, I believe, at their helm to steer them through this challenging period. Professor Wayne Powell was appointed Principal and Chief Executive of SRUC in July last year, and he has already overseen an additional 5 new senior management team and 2 new academic appointments, adding to the wealth of experience already at SRUC. It's also been announced recently that Sandy Cunningham will take up the position of SRU Chairman in October. I mentioned already that Hugh Hall has become Principal and Chief Executive of Fife College from the 1st of March this year. These are men with proven track records at the forefront of further and higher education, and we welcome them and look forward to their energy and vision benefiting not just SRUC and Fife College, but also the people of North East Fife as they find the right solution with stakeholders in the area. Members have also highlighted a variety of other points which I shall try to pick up on. Alex Shelley is quite right to point to the wealth of tourism opportunities within the Fife area. I'm sorry, I missed him when he was at the Fire Station Creative last night. I heard it went very well. There are also other places for the Citizens Spire, I would suggest, perhaps in the Dunfermline constituency, but we will take that perhaps for another conversation. Jenny Gilruth also pointed to the importance of the Leavenmouth rail link, which I appreciate as one of the rail links being looked at in Fife, and I believe the Transport Minister is encouraging all the campaign groups within the area to bring their business cases forward. It will be a welcome development in Fife if we can see investment like that. So I do know that the Transport Minister is very keen to ensure that all types of community campaigns for rail links develop their business cases and ensure that that's brought forward. On wider student issues, Mark Ruskell mentioned student support. He will no doubt be aware of the current student support review that is ongoing, which is looking at the very aspects of how we can have a system which benefits not only those in FE and ITCHE and ensures that we value the students in both. And can I say very gently to Dean Lockhart, however, about encouraging students from overseas? It would really help us if the UK government could clarify the status of EU nationals after Brexit and perhaps have an immigration policy which would allow us to bring more international students into the country. So you have my full support on that. I think Mr. Lockhart makes a very important point, and I hope he's making it to the UK government and his Conservative colleagues at the same time as the Scottish government. He will have my full support on that.
Willie Rennie, but I have to say, the Minister, you are coming close to overtime.
Yeah.
Mr. Rennie.
I welcome what she's had to say, but could you perhaps address the point about timing, that if we're going to have some format, some viable option for the future, and we want it in place for the academic year 2018-19, we need decisions to be made quite soon. Could she address that issue?
Minister.
With presiding officer warning me about my timing, I will refer him to what I've already said about SRUC's commitment to encourage new students for this academic year. Presiding officer, I hope that members have been assured about this government's continued support for further education, higher education support provision in North East Fife, and I'm more than happy to continue to work with members in this chamber and indeed other local representatives to ensure that we find the right solution for the people in North East Fife and the economic realities that we want to bring to that area can come to fruition with a very well-supported further education institution remaining within that area. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Minister. That concludes the debate, and I suspend this meeting of Parliament till 2:30.